हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। आई एम ऑडिबल?
यस सर, यू आर ऑडिबल।
या थैंक यू। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी। वंस अगेन आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टू द फोर्थ डे ऑफ 5 डे नेशनल लेवल एफटीपी ऑन मोबाइल एप्लीकेशन डेवलपमेंट यूजिंग एंड्रॉइड ओएस। टुडे वी हैव विद अस मिस्टर मधु जे एंड मिस्टर किरण कुमार फ्रॉम डिजिपिक्स टेक्नोलॉजीज बैंगलोर। I would like to introduce resource persons of today, Mr. Madhu and Kiran. Mr. Madhu is working as senior software engineer at Capgemini and an Android application developer and freelancer. He worked for Mahindra First Choice Wheels, a leading product-based company in second-hand cars in India, as an Android developer. He is working as a freelancer application developer at DigiPix Technologies from past 2.5 years. He has done internship and worked on some of the prestigious projects as a freelancer. I would like to welcome Madhu J for this today's session. Also, I would like to introduce Mr. Kiran Kumar. Yes, he is working as a junior Android application developer at Farnet's Digital Advertisement Private Limited, and he is working as a freelancer application developer at DigiPix Technologies from 2 years. So with this a short introduction, I would like to call upon Madhu Jay and Kiran Kumar to take over the session. Thank you. I think it is not audible.
हेलो, इट इज ऑडिबल? Hello, is it audible?
Yes, okay. Sir, you are audible. Oh,
sorry for the interruption. Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay. Thank you for a brief introduction, Mr. Narasimhamurthy. So, welcome everyone for today's session. So, as you all know, we have PDF, right, with you all. Can anyone reply?
Which PDF, sir?
Program. Okay, the application list which we are going to perform today.
Yeah, soft copy will be there, but we have not sent anything.
Yes, yes.
But they will be. You can start the program. They will track it.
Fine, not an issue.
Okay.
We can start directly with the programming. I don't want to waste your time. So, as per the functionalities and the requirements of the application. So we are starting with the media player application. Let me present my screen.
Sir?
Am I audible?
You have not shared your screen, sir?
Yes, yes, I am sharing. Just give me a moment.
Okay.
Can you see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So So from the past days, you have learned how to start the project and create the project, right? I want it to be interactive. So anyone can talk, please.
Sir, you can continue with the program. So if they have any doubts, they'll ask, sir.
Okay. So here we are creating a new project. Just click on that new project. You will get all the basic activities. So you can start with directly, like we have Google Maps activity and login activity and add more. So all this we have. So as a practice, we are going to start with the empty activity. Okay. So empty activity. So we can customize however we want with this activity. So if you want to start with the basic functionality like navigation or something else, you can directly select here and you can move ahead. So first I'll select the empty activity. So this is the application name which we are going to enter here. And it also acts as a package name here in the second edit text. So we are going to develop media there in our first session, right? So just click on finish. And the Android Studio will take some time for indexing and building the Gradle so that it will make the project ready to work on.
Internet.
Okay. Let us wait for the Gradle build. So I think you people are familiar with all the functionalities. Not sure. Is my screen visible?
No, sir.
No. This is from Kiran Kumar. The screen is shared from Kiran Kumar. Okay, give me a second. Let me present again. Now, is it visible?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So you got me right, or do I need to start over? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Do I need to start over, or you people got this how to start with the project?
No, sir. You can continue because 3 days. Oh. Everything is controlled.
Yeah. That's what I wanted to know because I'm not aware of those things. Okay, we'll start with the main activity. So, the first thing we have to do here is we need to start with this layout design. Firstly, we'll design the layout as per our requirements. So there is a constant layout. Let me start with the linear layout, which is the easiest one for the beginners. Okay. You just need to click linear layout. Okay. So you'll get the drop down with the available options. So linear layout, which we are going to use now. Okay. So let me request this as well. Okay, so this is the first text view which we want to show what the page is going to do. So we can replace directly here, and the best practice is to replace the string in the resource folder. You will get values and here string sorter. So you can add a string value here. So the format of adding string value is shown above. We can give the activity name and say it, okay. Activity name. Okay. This is going to be the name, string name, which we are using. So here we can write activity. Yes, for name. So the value will be written here. So this is the media player, right? So we can call media player. Okay. So that we can use this string anywhere in our project. If you are going to replace the word like this, the string value directly here means. So you can use only in this layout activity, not in any other activity or any other XML. So you can directly define that in the string.xml file so that we can call this name directly.
So which program you are doing? Can you just tell the name of the program and you can continue?
Name of the program. The name of the program is Media Player Application.
Okay.
Okay, so we are going to use this in our XML layout. So just if you are typing here text means, it will give, and here you can use the string values here. You can see in the drop down list. The first one which I have created is shown here. String/activity name. So you just enter this, so you will get here. We can design as per our requirements. So So before it was constant level, right? So why all these parameters are defaultly created? So we don't need anything of this, and we can give the layout gravity. Okay. So gravity, it works as the center or bottom, left or right, or we can call left as a start or right as the end. So we'll give center right now. Okay. So inside the linear layout, we need to provide the orientation. Orientation we have two, right? One is vertical and a horizontal. Vertical means whatever the components we are using inside this linear layout is going to be in a vertical order. Like I have a text view right here. So let me add another text view for your understanding. So there are two text views, right? If I give orientation as a vertical, so vertical, one after other will come in a line by line, the first component and the second component like this. Let me give the horizontal means it will sort one next to another, okay, like this. So let me give orientation as vertical because we are using other components as well, like seat bar and other buttons for the media player, right? So I don't want this one. I will give. Okay. So we can give the text size as well here. just type size, it will show in the drop down, which is a text size portion. So you can click on enter, or you can give directly some 20 SP. Okay, so activity media player we can use here. So we can customize this for the style as well. Text style, we can have normal or italic, or you know what all these styles means, I hope. So we can, so in this layout, our media player text view is on top of the screen. So I don't want here, means if I want to give some space in the top, means we can directly give margin. Margin top is the margin, means this will give the space in all the ways, like top, bottom, left and right. So margin top is specified only for the top margin. So let me give the top margin. So this can be specified in dp, so 10 dp, let me say something like this. So you can see the space now, right? So let me give some 50 so that you will get how it works, right? So we can customize as per requirements. We have color, like background color is there. You can customize background for that text view. So we can have some default colors will be there, like white or black, or like the background color, some like this is the application's colors are there, which are default to our applications in color. So let me give black right now.
Text color.
Okay. So we cannot see the text right now. So if we give background as black, the text color is also black, so that we can't see anything. So we can also customize the color for the text. You can see here text color, right? So and directly the center and give color as white. So can you see now? So I think this looks good. We can also have we have also padding. So if you are not aware of the padding means, so there is a difference between, let me add padding right now, then I will tell the difference. So padding, I will give some 10 dp. okay. So padding means you can see inside this, so this is the text view, right? Margin means this text view is going to have some width or some space around it. Like if this is the text view, means it is going to have the space of outside of this view. So padding means it is going to give the inside space itself. So let me give you. If this is 50, you can see the text is inside after the text, around it we have 50 dp of padding, right, left and top, bottom. Okay, so let me remove this, I don't need any padding right now, right? So you got the difference between margin and the pad. So let me add a image view right now for our application. So you can directly tell me image view. So if you press enter, you will get these stars. So think you are aware of this one, or let me explain again. So width, layout width means this is the view, one view. So for this view, what is the width you are going to give? So there are two contents for that, wrap content and match parent. If I give a wrap content here, it is going to Okay, let me explain that here only. Okay. So with wrap content is there. Wrap content means whatever the content we are writing inside this layout, like activity media player is there right now. So for that content, it is going to wrap the layout, right? So if I give this as a match parent, so this is going to take whole screen size as a width. So whatever the screen size you have of your phone, that is going to match that one, match parent. What is the parent screen size? That is going to match by this view. And height also, height works the same way as the width. So if I say match parent, it is going again to consider all the parent size, the complete parent size. The top, why it is not covering means we gave the margin top, so it is not going to cover that. So it is better to have in most of the cases the wrap content for the height, especially for the height, and width is as per our requirements. So you can see now layout, if I give the layout width as match parent, the inside text is going to align at the left of the layout. So what if I wanted to set this text in the center or the right side as per our requirement? So let me tell you another gravity. So this is called layout gravity. This works for the whole layout, right? Whole layout. So let me give a gravity. This is just a gravity, not a layout gravity. So this acts inside the view. Okay, inside the view, whatever the components we have, so in what type we wanted to align that, so that it is going to consider. So if I say it as center, it's going to come center. Okay, so let me, if I give it a bottom, so let me make this as much parent, and if I set it to bottom, we have bottom option. If I give it to bottom, it is going to come bottom. So let me, and we have center horizontal, center vertical as well. Okay, so let me align this for center right now, and this will be our wrap content. So let us move for the image view. Image view width and height, I'm going to consider as wrap content because I just wanted to wrap that image, whatever the size it is. Okay. So this is not showing right now. Okay. This is not going to the right now. So let me add the source for that image. Okay. So we can have directly, we can add directly our image into this drawable folder. So by default we have two icons, which is used for application. Okay. So in this drawable folder, whatever the resources and the extra XMLs we are using for the backgrounds, we are going to store that in this drawable folder. So in this values, we have, as I said, color system. If you want to give the color values, we can directly give. So by defaultly in my Android Studio, we have these many colors, and we can give as many colors as you want. The strings, as you know, in this one, let me go back to my layout. Okay. So in this source, we are going to add a background image. So IC launcher, this is a default one. So let me add this one. Okay, you can see this is the default image what we have right now. So let me add this in the center of the top of the layer. So again, same, we have layout gravity. Let me set it as center, and let me give some margin around it. I'll give some 30 dp margin. Okay. Okay. Give me a second. Okay. we'll create an vector asset. Vector asset for right now. So I'll tell you what is the vector asset and which are the icons given by Android Studio. So this is a vector asset so that we can replace our image with the inbuilt images. So we have if we click in the clipboard, we'll get all the available assets. So for our media player, right, we'll just search for like music or something. Okay, we got music. So we'll add this one. This looks good, right? Okay. So we can customize the size here and the color if we want. I want some blue color or something like green color. Okay. This one. Choose. So you can see here, right? Music video can you hear? So this is going, this name we are going to use in our layout file. So just click next and it is going to store in drawable folder. Click finish. So you can see here music where we have. So let me replace that one. I see. So naming conventions also you have to know because that is also important. So we can see here the size is very less, so we cannot see that properly. So we can directly go to this XML. We can give it height and width. Let me give some 50. So this is going to work for us. This should work for us. Let me see. Okay, or else let me give directly here. This size, let me add that content. So I can customize height and width as well. This should work, I think. Any margin is there. Any second. Okay, we have got this, and let me remove this to the default one. Okay, so we got it now. So 250 is the largest, right? 100 deep. Okay, this looks good for us. So let me move ahead, margin again. So just click on the plus button. So this view will be closed. Okay, let me add another linear layout which is going in the bottom so that we have three buttons which is going back the next song and the previous song and the linear layout again. You can use as many as linear layout inside another linear layout as you want. This it will be transparent and this will be content
orientation.
In this case, I'm going to use orientation as horizontal. let me write inside this linear layout a three text view we want to request it as the text view to display the status of our music. We have this width will be wrap content and height will be height also be one wrap content for this text view. Okay. Then we'll give some gravity. No, we'll give weight in this case. Weight, which is we are going to give one. I'll explain why I gave this weight as one. So let me end this and I'll just copy paste this three times because I want three text views. Okay. So the weight acts as inside the linear layout. If I give weight to all the views inside that linear layout, so it is going to give the space for all the components equally. So this linear layout is going to assign space all for all the views equally. So you can see three text views got the same width. So I can give this layout gravity to the bottom. Now to leave this as a bottom right now. Right now I just wanted to customize this one, right?
Super.
Okay. Let it be. We'll customize as per our requirements in the next session. Like in the next part. So we are going to have. So we are going to have a seek bar right now. We have seek bar here. So we'll give this seek bar as a width as a match parent and height as a wrap content. Let me give. Okay. I give this as both as a width as a match parent and height as a wrap content. So this is enough for right now, and we have to give the ID, and I'll tell you what the ID is. Right. Let me give some height as for this sequel. We'll give some 50 dB. So right for our music, this looks good. 50 dB.
Four button.
So we have a seek bar and a linear layout of three text views, and we are going to have another linear layout with some buttons for forward and backward of the music. We are going to have this as match parent. And height as a wrap content in the orientation. So for linear layout, orientation is mandatory. We can give this a horizontal. Inside this linear layout, we are going to write some buttons. Just click on this, you will get the button. Width will be wrap content, and height also we are going to have a wrap content. And
let me
We have to give this ID, and we are going to get that ID while we are getting to the actual program, the main activity. Okay, so we'll set text on that the button so that empty can let it be empty for right now on this button. Okay, so I just want to close this. Copy paste everything. So you can see if I give orientation as horizontal, and if I not give the weight, it is going to align one after other in a horizontal way. So if I give weight, the weight as one, so this is going to take the half of the linear layout space. So let me copy paste this one, this layout, as well as this layout. So I think this is for forward, backward, top, and pause. I think we want another button. So we have all the four buttons. This one. Let me give some margin so that you can understand. Your margin some. Let me give some 5 dB. Okay. So let me copy all this in all the buttons. Okay. And here as well. So you can see all the four buttons. So let us create a string for this.
Sir, how did you create a space between the two buttons is the question from the chat box.
Okay. Let me tell you that one. So this is just a margin. As I told before, I gave just a margin of 5 dp in all the buttons. So let me consider the first button. So you can see here we have gap from the starting and from the top and the bottom and the side as well, right side as well, right? So I gave for this button and all the buttons, so this is going to create a gap right side of this as well, and this is going to and the second button is going to give a space of 5 dp. So this is a total of 10 dp. So you are seeing a space in between the buttons. Did you get it? Or let me make this as some 50.
Yeah.
You can see around this button we have a space of 50 dp for the left, right, and the top and the bottom, right? Did you get it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you got it.
Thank you.
Okay. So, let me add string values for this one. So why we are using... Okay, let me... Just give me a second. Okay, so on this one we need to have some indications, right, for moving forward, backward, and all. So for that one, as I said before, we are going to create that in a string file. Okay, so we can comment it and we can get to know why we are doing for this. This is button indication. Button indicators we have. So let me make this as a comment so that it is not going to affect my actual program. Okay. So let me copy this one. I don't want to waste time by typing everything. Okay, so for four buttons it is there, right? So I'm pasting four times this one. So we have four string values, and the first value I'm going to say it as a rewind or a back. This I'm going to say it as back. Okay. This is going, and here we are having we have to define that one in a given format, right? Because this is as these are the special characters, we are going to specify in a particular manner. Okay. This is the arrow we are using. Okay. Wait a second. Okay. So this is the format we are using to define arrows, because as you can see in this programming, to define a value, a string value, we are using right arrow and left arrow, right? So that if we want to use the same as a text means, we need to have that in this format. Okay, so let me add this again. So this is the format. Copy this and paste here. I think I should not copy. Right, this much. Copy this and place in the place of here. Let me add inside these brackets, we will be having two arrows which indicates the back, and the two arrows which indicates the forward. Let me change the name. So this has a forward and this has a rewind. Okay. And I don't, I just wanted the pause button also, right? So I'll name it as a pause, and I just give for this one, no need to have any special format. We can directly give this one. So we can use all these names, back, rewind, forward, and pause directly in this layout, so that we should not write inside a text directly, right? So for the first one, we are going to have a forward button. Okay, just type forward. It will show the recommendation, right? Inside the string, we have forward, this one. So you can see that the forward arrow, right? Here. Okay. So let me add the next one, pause. This one is a pause. The next one is, the the back one, and the last one we have is the rewind. Okay, so we customized all these buttons and with the sequence, right? So this is enough for right now, and we'll customize this in the last so that it should come in the end of the page. So let me come to the main activity. So we first will define the buttons and the text view which we have used in the activity so that we can use in the main activity. So let me close this one. So this we don't have to give ID for this because we are not setting anything. This is hard coded, and for image also nothing, and for this text view we are going to have an ID. Okay, let me give for now as a simple name. We should mention inside this ID. Okay, ID only we should mention. And we have this is the text view, right? I'll give text view one. This is the first text view, and I'll copy this one and paste in all the text views. Here. Okay, we have three text views, right? So I'll replace it as two, text view two, and this as text view three. So that we'll define this also as per our understanding. So for our reference, I'm going to give some text inside this one so that we can recognize that. So I will give you as text view. Okay, this is a text view. I will copy this one. Let me add here as well as here. So this has text view 2 and 3. Okay, so that you can recognize here some text views are there. So let me define that text views. Okay, you can have a text view here. Then you can give some names for the text views. Let me give as text view 1. Comma, how many text view 3 we have? So text view 2, comma, text view 3. So we just defined our object of text view with the three names. So inside onCreate method, we are going to assign that layout text view ID to these text view variables. So let me, the first one is text view 1, right? So text view 1, you can see in the drop down whatever the created variables will come here. So is equal to text view. You can use find view by ID. Find view by ID means we are finding a view inside our the layout. This layout is defined here. You can see activity main is our layout. So for every activity, there will be a different XML file, which is a layout file. So if I find view by ID, if I give this one, means this is going to find a view by ID in this layout. Okay, so let me in this one, find view by ID, we are going to define r.id. So this is referring to the text view ID in this layout, and we have the first one, text view. Okay, that is going to show us available text views. So now we have successfully added this text view to this variable. You can see if I control and click here, this is going to take us to this text view. Okay, so like this, we are going to define all the three text views first. Okay, this is the text view 2, right? And this is the text view 3, and here also, this is text view 2. The text view 3. For third text view, we have assigned our text view. Sorry, this is 2, this is 3. Right. Okay. So next, we are going to define the buttons in the same way. So where are the buttons? Buttons. So, okay, we can give the ID. This one, ID. First one, I'll just give it as a button. Second, I'll just copy paste and I'll just rename it the numbers. And here we have another. We four buttons, right? So yeah, we first one will be the button as itself, and this one is button number we say it as 2, and here we say it as 3, then this is the fourth button, right? So just as we did for the text view, we do it the same way for the buttons. So for the buttons, again we have to create an object of button with some names. So we'll write it as button start, button pause, and forward, then comes backward. So we can understand by this. We can easily understand by this rather than button 1, 2, 3. So here, while we are defining, we are giving the appropriate button. We are assigning the button to that variable. For the start one, start is equal to find view by ID or dot ID dot the button, right? And see here the buttons which are available. So the first one, the button, right? Let me check, is this the right one or not? To start, right? Okay, we'll be having this, and the second one will be, let me copy paste this one. Let me copy paste all this. Okay, this is the start one, and this is the pause, the second one, and this one is forward, the last one is backward. Okay, so start button 3, give me a second. So this one is the let me rename it because I missed the okay, let it be this is the button. So this is the button third. So this will be our start button, and we have the second pause button as a 2, and the first one is a forward, and the last one is a backward. Okay, so we have successfully find these buttons from our programming. Okay, so the next thing what we have to do is we have to we have to add a music into our resource file so that we can play a music. So we are not going to take this from gallery, and that will be it is going to take another 1 hour 2 hours extra time. So I will be creating a new directory called raw. So inside this one, so for this one, I'm going to add a music which is available in my computer. Okay. So I wanted to add this one. Let me get that music from somewhere. So by that time, let me create an object for the media player. So for media player, we have to create an object of media player. So we have media player object. and we'll say it as media player. And we'll create using that media player, we are calling the create method. Media player is equal to the media player object dot create. So this is going to create a media player for our application. So inside this, we need to pass our context of our application. So in the main activity, we can use this as a context. And then now here we have to pass our music. So our means this is the resource value. Inside the resource, we have our dot raw we have created, and I'm going to add that music. So that music file name we are going to add here. Let me give sample music for now. Till the time I get music, let it be. It is showing error. Let me add that music. If I add that music, it will be right. So we are going to create an object for sigbar. Now just copy and paste this one. Give it a sigbar. So this is going to refer the sigbar object which we have created right now. And let me give the ID for that sigbar. For this sigbar, we are going to give ID, and let me give sigbar here as well. Okay, and just copy this one, then paste it here. So we have successfully pointed that our sigbar in layout to the object, to the variable. So sigbar dot set clickable, we are going to give it as a false because we don't want to click on that sigbar for right now. Okay, let me create for the button. We are going to on click of this button, we are going to do some functionality, some operations, right? So for the button which we have the start one, where is that, the third button, right? Yeah, so for this button we are going to set the music to be played. So where is the third button? Third, the start. Okay, for this copy and have pick the start button dot set on click listener. We are creating a new on click listener for that button. So you will be getting the methods, and inside we have a on click clause. So inside this, what we are going to do is, first we want to check the button is clicked or not. So we'll give a toast message so that we will get to know the button is clicked or not. Okay. Let me. Make text, and we have the get application context, comma, the text we want to display when clicked on that button. So I'll say start button is clicked. Okay. So after this, just give a comma and toast. We are passing the toast, right? So toast dot the length of the this toast message. So I'll give just a short, then come outside dot make text. So this is going to show. So it's done. So after clicking that media player dot start, we are going to call that media player to start our music. Then let me so after this, we are going to set the text, right? Text view 2 for the second text view. But we have 3 text views, right? So we are going to set the text for the text view. And we are telling, we are just telling that it is, the music has started. Okay. Give me a second. So for the text view, we are setting the text, right? For this text view, we are giving time duration in the time units, dot milliseconds, dot 2 minutes, which is, this is the type of long, right? So we are mentioning that as well. Long of final time, we are we can take it as a final time. So this is for the minutes. So we want to show that minutes, right, for that music which we are playing. So next, we are going to set seconds, right? Give me a moment. 2 minutes of long final time. Let me create that final time. Yes. Let me create that final time and final time in the variables. So this is a type of double, and we are defining that variable start time and the final time. Private is equal to, and this is, we don't require. Okay, it's okay. Let it be. So we have created the variables. So let me come to the media player class. So here we are setting the time of minute and the seconds, right? So this is our milliseconds in the minutes, and this is in the milliseconds in the second format. Now we are taking that time minute dot 2 seconds. This, we are converting that minutes into a seconds. So let me add this one, and time unit dot milliseconds dot, we are converting that to minutes, which is a type of long, and we are setting that to final time. Some bracket issues, I think. Let me check. Here it's been here. Okay. Okay. So we have set the text for the media player, the time and the seconds, minutes and the seconds. So we are going to do this for again the text view, 1. the same thing, but we need to. So for the seek bar, we have to set the progress, which is in the integer form of start time. Start time we took, we have configured just now, and we have set that. Then let me create a handler for this one. So let me create here a handler. Handler type my handler is equal to new handler. Just we are creating a handler object so that we can use that handler. And here we use my handler dot post delayed. After the delay, we are going to update the some time. So for updating some time, we need to we'll write for now, and we'll create that method of updating some time. Okay, the time is going on, so let me copy and paste that code and let me explain that one. So or else it will going to take a long time. So this is just a class, so what we are using to update the song time. As you can see, as we have done previously, this is the same thing for this media player. Again, we are going to get the current position, then we are setting for that view the time, whichever we in the minutes and seconds, we are going to set that time again. So the same thing which we have did here, so that is the same thing we are doing now. So using this class, we are updating the song time time in the seek bar. So post delayed, I'm going to call that update time, this one, update time method. Let me have that media player. This media player is defined globally. I think, give me a second. So we have media player already. So let me do this first. That is that one. Okay. For this updating time, we are delaying the time with some 100 seconds. Okay, 100. And so for this button two. Issue with this buttons. Let me check what happened. Give me a second. So we have pause button. For that, we are set think it's at an blue. So for pause button, we are setting it as true. Okay. So then for the next button, which is start button, dot set enabled false. We are setting the start button as false and pause button as enabled when this function calls. So let me call the pause button when on click of that pause button. So pause dot set on click listener of new on click listener. Here again I'm taking the toast message. So let me copy all this and I'll add here. Yeah. So this is when clicked off the pause button, right? Pause button. So okay, when clicking of this pause button, we will again calling the same two buttons with swapping these values. False. Okay. So when click on this one, we are setting this pause as false and this as true. So this should continue, right? When after clicking the pause and the pause button twice. So next we have, so after this pause button, we have to go for the forward button, forward dot set on click listener of new view dot on click listener. Inside this one, we are going to create a temporary variable. Let me call it as temp. Is equal to, this is a type of integer I'm creating. So let me call it as an integer. I'll call start time. Yeah. So I'm writing a condition here to forward the song if the temp plus the temporary variable, which is the temporary is set to start time, right? So temporary, which is a start time plus forward. Let me create another time called start time and the backward time for this functionality. Start time and the backward time, right? So let me create again two variables with which is a type of integer for time. Forward time is equal to, let me give some 5 seconds of pause. Next. Okay, this is a private. Then I'll copy this. I'll paste here. I'll make it as a backward time again. Backward time. Okay. So let me go back to my on click of the forward button. Here, let me call that variable which I have created, forward time. Forward time plus start time, right? So adding these two times will be assigning to final time. Okay. So if this condition is true, we are going inside of this if clause, then I'll set the start time is equal to start time plus forward time. So this is going to move our song for the 5 seconds, adding forward time. Okay, let me end this. Then we'll call the media player seek var media player dot seek var. Okay, I think seek okay, media player two. Yeah, we have seek two method, which is a type of integer. We are calling the start time. So if this works, means we need to get a toast message if this works properly. So we'll add a toast message so that we got to know this worked fine for us. Let me tell for 5 seconds. Okay. Else. And write else clause. Else again, if this not happens, I'll add this word again. Toast message with I'll tell forward and not forward. For this is going, we are going to do the same operation for the backward as well. So let me add copy paste this one and I'll add backward. Then I'm changing some functionality inside this one. So again, temp minus backward time. Let's say temp minus backward time is greater than zero. If this condition is true, we are coming inside. Start time is equal to start time minus backward time. Okay. So the same thing happens here, but we'll change the toast message backward for 5 seconds. Not backward is failed. We cannot back. So for this we have successfully done for the backward and forward functionalities. So let me check what happened with this one. This is a sequence, this is a media player which we have defined earlier, but it is not taking. So we need to add a music file as well. Okay, let me add that music file first. Just give me a second. Give me a second. I'll be adding the music for that one. Give me a moment. just a minute. They are adding music. Have any music? I think the connection is not good. Just give me a moment. May I add that music? By that time, I will be checking with this memory of the year what happened. Let me make it as a so I am adding the music to the draw file. Okay, sample. This is the music. So we have added the music. Let me check with this media player. let it be just now. Okay, let me run this first, then we'll check with what happened. Let me run on my emulator. I think the design is, we need to make some changes, like these buttons and sidebar should come at the bottom of the page. So the Gradle build is running, we'll see what happens. Next. So you can see it is installing and yeah, now it is opening. So you can see here. Let me give some volume. I don't know if we're getting more volume or not. So emulator is not visible, right? So let me reshare my screen. I thought the emulator, you can able to see emulator. So we have executed this program. Let it run.
Screen is not shared, I think, Madhu.
It is not shared. Just give me a second. I thought it was shared. Yeah, now it is visible, right?
Yes, no.
Okay.
Now come.
Okay. So let me execute this one. We can see the activity is launched. Okay, the buttons are working fine and the sidebar is also looks good, but it is not playing the song, right? Give me a moment, we'll configure this this one and we'll see what happened. So let us put it in bottom. I'll give some margin top so that it. This looks fine. Give me a second.
At 5 hours, 5 hours.
Give me a moment, I'll be checking with this one. Just a second. click once. Okay. So shall I run? Okay, I'll run this one. Let me check what happens. I have made some changes with this. What we have defined the object, right? With media player. So I had some issue with that. So, and I have added that music file as well. So let me check with that Android emulator. So the song is playing, but I'm not able to hear that one on this display. You can check with this one, right? The sig bar is moving according with the song time, and we can media play time change as per this one. And it is forwarded. You can see right here the time is changing. When I clicked on the forward button, it is going 5 seconds forward every time when I clicked. And when I click the backward button, it is going 5 seconds backward, right? So this is what the application requirements which we have seen in the PDF. So, so you people got right how we have done with these functionalities to change the time, like moving forward with the music player and the backward one. The backward one. Right, you got it right, people. Can anyone speak up? Is there any doubt or else? You got it right, how to define a button. And let me tell you again the overview of this. So it's fine. Okay. So first, what I'll tell what I have done from the beginning. So first, we from this main activity, we just came to the layout, and we have designed all the layout views, as I explained, the text view, image view, and the buttons. Everything we have configured in this page with the sig bar and the image view, everything. So to get this text, we have configured that in the string XML file, and in the raw we have created a directory called raw. In that one we have added our music. Then coming to the main activity, we had defined, so every variables we are using inside our program, so that should be defined globally, right? So after defining globally, so I have not defined everything at a time while getting into the functionality as per our requirement. At that time we have created every variables, but the buttons and the views we have configured in our layout, that should be defined at the starting of the program. So by this find view ID, we have referred all the buttons and views which are present in our main layout. So you got to know how to write on click listener for a particular button or a view or a sig bar, whatever. So these are functionalities we have, like this is a logic we have did for music sequence to move forward and backward, and setting text, everything on click of pause. Should pause and forward. And these stuff. So you got it right. Can anyone reply? Or is there any doubts regarding this one? Actually, we have prepared this code. Yeah, tell me. Someone is speaking, right?
Sir, in that follow-up,
yes.
Music video 24xml. So can you explain?
You are not audible properly for me. Can you come again?
Sir, in the drawable folder, you have created that baseline music video.xml, some file.
Yes. Okay. Okay. So this is a vector asset, we say, in this Android Studio. If on click of drawable, if you right click here, you can see the new components which we can add inside the drawable. Right, so here we have image asset and vector asset. Right, vector asset, image asset means if you click on the image asset, you can import the library images which are provided by the Android Studio. When you install this, all the components, images are available for ready to use images. Right. So you vector, I'll tell you the difference between vector and image asset. Image asset only have the images like this. You can directly select this one and you can give next, and that will be added in this drawable folder so that you can directly refer that in your XML layout. But when you take a vector asset, you can customize that one, that image as well. If you say vector asset, so I get this color. So here on the clip part, if you click here, you will get all the available like PNG formatted images, which is in the form of vector. Vector means a path is defined for every image. I'll tell you that one. So here a lot of image vector assets are available to ready to use, like you would have seen this and all, right? Settings and then night mode in your mobile, somewhere in your mobile, like camera, we can have this also, like calling buttons, like everything is available. So you just search here and take that set, and just you can give the size here as well. Or else, if you want to do a customization, you can just add here. And if you open that file, you will get the image in a vector format. Okay. So here you can see the path is there, right?
So this will be added by itself after selecting those options.
Yes. That will be added automatically. This file will come automatically so that you can configure however you want. As you see, I have gave this width as per my requirement, like that.
Okay. So I have to use this in activity main.xml. So this image.
Yes. Yes. Directly you can use this name as I use here. If you click here, you can see drawable source. For this, the source which I have taken from the drawable, you can directly use that name with the drawable. At drawable is there, right? It will refer to the drawable folder, and inside that, the name of the file.
Sure. Thank you.
Is this good? So let us move ahead with the next application. Or else we'll take a 5 minutes of break. Anyone can reply? 5 minutes.
Sir, one question is asked in the chat box. So just can answer the question.
Yes, just give me a second. Let me open. To give a space between buttons in a linear layout that I explained, right? That is a previous one. And the music file is in which format? Can't be open in MP3. Okay. So the music files is added in a raw folder, as I mentioned in this. We can open the MP3, but as I told before while doing this programming, so it will take another 1 or 2 hours time to open from right away from the gallery. We can take that as well. Nothing is impossible in this Android. So as you are aware, like you are using many applications, so all the applications, many apps have all of the most of the features which we require. So we can do the same way. There is no issue with that. But as I told, it will take some time. So our agenda is to do this much of app for the media player. So we have done with that. Okay, then shall we take 2 minutes of break? Then we'll get back to the next application.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, sure. So I'll be back in just 3 to 5 minutes. So let me start another. Okay, then. So I think you people are back. Right. Please reply if you are back. We can start with the next. Again, it will take the next one is a simple app and it will take around 20 minutes. So we'll end up this session for right now with that application. So let me complete that in a quick way.
That app is to store and create and save file in Android.
So the next application is the fourth one, which is a file application, right? So the requirement is write a program to create an activity having a text box and also save, open and create buttons. So the thing is there should be a three buttons to save, open and create. If I click on open, that text inside that text file should be showed on our text view or edit text. So if the file is not created, there should be a toast message which shows us the file is not being created yet, right? And yeah, so those are the three operations we are doing: create, open and save.
Sir, can you please share your screen?
Yes, I'm doing that. Okay, can you see my screen? Okay, let me create another project called with an empty activity, which is called file manage. Okay, finish this. It'll take some 2 minutes of time to build. Let us wait for that. Okay, the Gradle build has been completed. So as I said, we'll start with the design. First, we'll
design the screen.
Yeah, I'm sharing. Is it not
visible?
Okay, wait a second. Share. Okay, now is it visible? Okay. So as I told before, we are starting with layout design. So we'll go to the main activity layout and we'll make this as a linear layout. Linear layout. Okay. So we'll give orientation as a vertical, and we need a text view. These constraints are not required for a linear layout, and we'll say it as we'll give this text as a file application with some size, and we'll set the gravity also. Set the size first. So the text size will be, let us say, some 20 dp, and the layout gravity will be at the center. This should be a layout gravity. Okay, so that's enough for now. And we'll create two buttons inside a linear layout now. This will be a match parent, and this is a wrap content. So the orientation will give the orientation as horizontal for now. So we'll put the two button as per our design. So second. Inside this linear layout, we'll put two buttons. Okay. One button with the wrap content, and right also wrap content. We'll put this text as we'll directly giving hard coding the text here. We are not using a string.xml file, but we should use that one. But for now, I'm giving directly here. So the first one is create button with the some margin of some 20 dp. Okay, then I'll give weight as well, layout weight as 1. Then I'll create another button. I'll just copy paste this one. Copy paste. So we have two button, and I'll name it as the open button, right? Open, okay. So yeah, so this is done for now. Let me give margin of ADP. Okay, so buttons are done for our file, and we'll have our edit text now. After the linear layout, we'll have a edit text. Edit text is for adding text and retrieving data again. Match parent content, and I will give some text hint. I will give. You hint to add text. Okay. So I'll add another button, which is to save. Which is to save the text which we have added in the edit text field. So I'll put some margin of TDP. Okay, this looks good. Okay, let us give the ID. So this is a simple application, right? So there is no need of a lot of design is required in this layout. So we'll give ID for all the buttons. So ID, this is a create, right? I will just write it as create. And this ID we have open. Open. And this is the edit text. I'll give it as edit text because we don't have any other edit text. So I'll just specify as edit text. Then for the button save, I'll specify ID as save. Okay. So this is all about design. We have a simple design here. So we'll go to the main activity now. Okay. So for this one, we'll create all the objects first, whichever we have defined in our layout. First, we'll we'll define the buttons. Button, we have save button, create button, and another one. Save, create, and read button. Right. Okay. Now we have edit text. Right. Edit text. Edit text. We just define, and text is enough. Then we'll create two strings, which is required for our further programming. And this is a type of string I wanted, which I call as a file name. And I want another string. So file name we can specify with a string, which is a sample file. Okay. So we'll define another string with the file path. String file path. Here we are giving it as a hard coded as my file storage. Okay, so this should be in a text format, right? The sample file should be in a text format. I'll say it as .txt. Okay, so after this I'll create a file object, file, and name it as my external file. So I want another string for my data which we are passing. So I'll specify as a string with naming as my data, which I'll set it as empty for now. Then I want another string as a create status. So we need to check whether the file is created or not before saving, right? So why I'm creating that string, and we want a text view with the named as a response for our further proceedings. So I want to define these values with the layout views. So save is a button, right? So save is equal to find view by id or dot id dot save. We have a save a view like a button, so we have two equals here. I'll remove one. Okay, I'll just copy and paste this give me a second. I'll copy paste this one and I'll rename this. So for create, we have a button called create, and for read, we have a read button. Okay, it's not read button. Let me check what is that name. Say open button. Okay, I read. Open button is there to read that data. So I'll define again the input text view. And the edit text. So edit text is equal to find id or dot id. What is the text view we have for what we have given the id? The edit text, right? Just copy here and paste here.
Sir, is it possible to maximize the screen? Because we cannot see view it very clearly.
Okay. Give me a second. Give me a minute.
Just check doing control plus and see. Let us check whether it is getting maximized. Control plus.
No, that is not working. So I am.
The screen is maximized, no, sir?
Sorry?
Is it maximized? Screen is maximized?
Yes, yes, screen is maximized. You can see that.
It is full screen only.
Okay. Then it's okay, sir.
You can see, right?
Yeah, okay, fine, sir. We have to a little bit strain. It's fine if you cannot do it.
Check, is this okay?
Yes, sir, it is very good now.
Okay. Okay. So where we are defining the say edit text, right? So next what we have, so we are now create button. So on click of this create button, we are doing some functionality, right? We are writing some functionality, create dot set on click listener of new on click listener. So inside this, so what we have to do is we need to take the file output stream. On click of this, we have a inbuilt method called file output stream, which is going to create a file for us. So we'll put it in a try and catch block, because if some exception is there, we need to handle that one as well. So we have file output stream here available. So file output stream, will I name it as FOS file output stream is equal to the new object of this one, which is a new file output stream of my external file, which I have created as a okay. Let me add the catch block
with IO exception.
With IO exception, and we'll add inside that e dot exception dot print statistics. So we are good to go with the try block. So we'll close this one. OS dot close. Okay. Then we'll create. We have a string, right? Create status. So we'll set this as one for now. Okay. So what do we have here? Change field type to int. Yes, this is integer, right? Create status should be int. No need to give anything. Okay. So we have set the create status to one when clicked on the create button. Okay. We'll so now after the try and catch block, we'll be having response dot set text. For the response, we are setting some text after getting the response. So we'll say that file is created successfully. In this create button functionality, we are doing only this much. So we'll continue with the save button. Okay. So I'll copy and paste this one, and we'll do some changes. So this is a save button, and here we'll put a condition if create status dot contains create status dot give me a okay, let me do it string only, and we will add make it as a string. We'll add this to a string. Now create status dot contains of one. Create status. So if this condition is true, we are going inside this one, and we'll close this bracket first. So in this one, after this FOS dot, we are going to write something into this file, right? Write. So what we have to write is we are taking the values, the string value which we are giving from the edit text, and we are so edit text dot get text. Get text is a method to get the text from that edit text, and we are converting this to a two string. Then we are taking the bytes from that string. Okay, so after writing the value into the file, we are just closing this one first dot close. Okay, so after the catch block, we want edit text dot set text to empty. after taking the values from edit text and writing it into the file, we are making the edit text again empty, so that we have written this one. And for response, in the response we are writing file is saved successfully. Okay, so this is the if condition. So inside the if condition, so we get this logic. Else that not happens, we are giving a toast message, toast dot make text of get application context. So as per our requirement, first create a file. If the file is not created, we are showing a toast message to create a file first, then you can save. Length short dot show. So this is the toast should pop up.
Sir, what does the first parameter tell us?
This is get application context, right?
Yes, sir.
So this is the context of this application, where for this activity, for the main activity, we have the get application context method, where it is referring to the main activity. Or if you are writing this in any other activity, it will be get application context. Or if you are using the context in some other classes, so if you have created your own class and writing some functionality, there you are not using get application context, because that is not an activity, that is just a class. So inside the class, you are defining a context in the global variable space. Here you are defining the context, and you are using only the context, not with the get application context. So this is only used for activities. Are you clear? For making a toast in that, from that activity, we are having get application context.
Okay.
We can give like this also. You can see, right, main activity dot this. So the toast message is referring from this activity, right? From main activity, this toast message is referring.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay. Yes. Okay, so it will be this toast message will be displayed in main activity.
Yes, no, that toast message is coming from main activity. We will get to,
okay.
No, yeah. So after save, what we have, read, right? Read or yeah, read button is left. So the concrete prisoner of a new complete listener. So in here, what we are writing, we want to have another try block to handle the exception. So this catch. Exception called E. Okay, let it be. So inside the try block, we are having a in file input stream. Okay, file output stream we use to set the text into that file. So text is going out. So here we are using file input stream to read the data from that file. Okay, so I'll take it as FIS is equal to new file input stream of my external file, right? From this file we are reading the data. Now data input stream, so to get the data, this is to read, and yeah, from the file we are using data input stream to get the data. So is equal to new data input stream of F5S. Okay, so now we have a buffer reader. So we have buffer reader PR is equal to new buffer reader of new input stream reader of, we are passing this data input stream into this buffer. Okay, so this is enough for us. So now we'll create a temporary string to get and store the data. So I'll type it as a str line. Then we are having a while loop here. While string str line is equal to br dot read line. Read line. So this is not equal to null means we are moving ahead. In this one, while loop, my data, I'm setting data to str line. Okay, if that is not null, I'm setting this value. So I'm closing this input stream. Then we have catch. I think. Input text. Now we have edit text. We are setting the data which we got right now. Set text of my data. We are setting my data into edit text. Now we want a response, right? I'll copy this one and I'll paste here. Great, sir. File read. Read is successful. Okay. Give me a minute. So it is taking a lot of time, right? Just give me a moment. Next data. So on the other line, we will type my data. So as it was taking a long time, I just added the code file manager. So where we are. So after this, we have, if the condition for external storage is available, if it is available, so we are enabling the save button. Or if it is not available, my external file in this storage path, the file will be stored. So again, we have other two methods where these two methods are not used anywhere in the code, just here to check whether the file external storage readability is available or not, read and write for that one. And manifest. So this is about the file thing. And so this will be checked based on the manifest file. Inside the manifest, we need to give the permission for the user to read and write the external file storage inside the mobile. So we will get this one. We can add the permission here. User's permission. So the name will be Android permission write external storage we want, right? So I'll just type write. So write external storage is available. So this is the permission we needed for the app. I think now we are good to go. So shall we run and we'll check what happens. So this is the simple program. The main methods where we use in this application are file input stream and output stream, and permission to check storage permission is available or not. Okay, the Gradle has finished. Now the activity is launching. We have not created the file right now. I'll click just on the save. Okay, you can see a toast message here, right? First create a file. So which is available, file is created somewhere. Okay. If I click on the create a file, okay. Give me a second, let me run once again. Okay. Let me save this file. The code is same actually. I'm running. So it has been saved now. So let me read the data. So we got the data. So let me replace that data with. Okay, let me replace that with this one. So if I click on save, that will be saved. You can see here. If I read, only that data is replaced in the file. So this is what the application is all about. So shall we wind up the call? It's been late by 40 minutes already. So we'll connect afterwards in the next session.
Okay, sir. Shall we start at 2 o'clock or 2:15?
2:15 we can start at 2:15.
Thank you so much, sir. Yeah, yes. Thank you all. We'll start the next session, afternoon session at 2:15 exactly. Thank you all.